attempts to create much-needed regulatory framework, enforcement capabilities, and penalizing powers for the Unique Identification Authority of India. Layers of encryption are being added to conceal the Aadhaar number and its data sets, which are appreciable. The idea of informed consent and protection of children by their guardians until adulthood are measures of a good public policy. Giving citizens the options to choose their preferred mode of identity verification and opening up the ambit of complaints to them are necessary to democratize the system. The bill stands firm on constitutional grounds as it states that no citizen will be denied services for want of Aadhaar verification. One cannot deny that the bill decentralizes funding by creating the UIDAI fund that will bring self-sustenance for the project in its own right. This is all positive. I'm sure that it is music ears for the Treasury benches. You must be elated to know that someone from the middle order in this August House is painting a rosy picture of this proposed legislation. You are free to think so, but I urge you to lend your ears equally to know the lurking dangers of our times. These days, the Big Brother tendency of the system itself prevails to haunt our citizens in subtle ways, subtler ways than one can imagine. Let me start reminding you again that I come from the state of Andhra Pradesh, which witnessed the country's biggest Aadhaar data leak, or you might say data theft. In the year July 2016, the then state government led by the Telugu Desam Party conducted the much-hyped Praja Sadharika, or Smart Public Survey. It collected the socio-economic and demographic data of 1.26 crore households in the state, citing that it was for a more effective delivery of welfare systems. Sir, in the name of welfare, the TDP government tricked the people into filling information gaps left behind by Aadhaar. In the government's own word, why don't you reply in your own when you get the chance? You can reply in your own chance.
See, nothing going
you
on.
You can reply when you get a chance. It collected the socio-economic and demographic.
Please be seated, please.
Sir,
if anything unparliamentary, definitely it will take care of.
In the government tricked the people into filling information gaps left behind by Aadhaar. In the government's own word, it possesses 60% of
Please try to avoid the allegations against the state governments and all. Please speak on the bill. Please.
In it, not knowing the dire consequence of this survey, people started furnishing details of caste, family, community, education, income, livelihood, whether they were beneficiaries of welfare schemes, and what amount they received for the same. The then government took all these details and uploaded them online through a eKYC-based verification system linked to Aadhaar. What then followed were a series of data leaks, or what you might say data theft, that exposed these details to the entire world. In 2018, the AP Housing Corporation website has disclosed personal information and bank details of about 1,34,000 people to several private agencies. Again, in June 2018, the AP state government portal www.ap.gov.in itself hosted Aadhaar link details of 4.5 crore residents living in the state. These details were directly taken from the smart survey, pulse survey data mentioned earlier. Again, in September 2018, the AP government put up an open database once again for more than 23,000 farmers and other tribals. Subsidies provided to them from AP Medicinal and Aromatic Plants Board, and all their personal data were open to all to access. The list of leaks were endless, growing until one day it all started making sense to the people. In early 2019, people witnessed the truth behind the politics when huge number of applicants were uploaded onto the Election Commission's website for removal of votes by the tune of lakhs in each parliamentary constituency. The then government conspired systematically. The then government We
please, please confine to the bill. Your time is already over.
You are disturbing, sir. Please. This is not fair. You are disturbing. This is not fair, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, can I finish my...
Yeah, please, please be seated.
This is my turn. This is my turn.
Please be seated.
Kindly, where's the music, sir?
No, no. Your time is already over. Please conclude.
No, I'm just repeating what happened. Everybody knows it's open to the
no, no,
whole
no, no.
world.
You cannot make any specific allegation. You can very well speak on the bill and your experience.
They systematically
the
using government servants, paid workers and party cadre to conduct a public survey, all to ensure that the voters profile them and manage the election process in the state. The private company DataGates poured life into illegal project by creating a Seva Mitra mobile application which was accessible to each and every ground cadre of the party up to the booth level and beyond. The Telangana State Forensic Science Laboratory revealed that a mammoth 7.8 crore records of Aadhaar data linked with Smart Pulse data were stored by a private company. These records that belong to the citizens of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh were linked with voter ID numbers, color photographs, names of family members, caste groupings, whether they were beneficiaries of welfare schemes, and the amount they received for the same. A statement was issued by an Aadhaar deputy director that the database structure, size, file formats recovered from the private company storage devices were similar to those maintained by the Central Identity Data Repository. Now, while the private company... This is against the private company. I don't know why you also so bothered. Now, while the private company was booked by Hyderabad police till date, not a single servant, government servant, paid worker or party cadre has been arrested. The TDP party was even prepared on the legal front. In fact, back in 2017, the state government passed an Andhra Pradesh Code Digital Data Authority Act, under which Section 37 states that no legal proceeding shall lie against any officer or employee for anything which is done in good faith. What this means is that the leaks and breaches are not something any official in the government can be held responsible.
Please conclude.
Almost done. Our present state government, led by our Honorable Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy, is striving to scrap such draconian sections of the state law. Under his leadership, we are prepared to ground door deliveries of welfare schemes. We are establishing gram secretariats in each village. Any eligible person can approach village secretariat and his request will be processed in 48 hours. I request the union government look into this model and for other states as well. With regard to this bill, no doubt it bars private entities from using Aadhaar-based information. But there is no clarity on norms and penalties when officials within the government themselves leak the information to private entities or open-source
web stores. Please conclude, please.
In this case, we all saw that if an incumbent government has strong will to indirectly pursue illegal means to an end, they can go ahead and execute it. Except today, what happened is exposed clearly.
Yes.
When
yes.
such obvious blunders are committed by a government,
yes, please
it is
conclude,
unclear.
Please. I have to call the other speaker.
Almost
please,
done. Almost done.
Yeah, please.
Almost done.
Yep.
The bill.
If you want to conclude by one or two sentences, please.
Yeah. I notice this bill provides.
Last sentence.
Finally, I would like to suggest the union government to incentivize independent security agencies research to report data weaknesses for monetary rewards and domain recognition. A lot of countries to strengthen their cyber defense is successfully implementing this. Sir, I would like to conclude by offering full support for this bill and amendments made in it. Our suggestions, rather than reacting
Thank
to the
you.
Situation,
Thank you. Next speaker is Sri Pinaki Mishra. Please conclude. Please, yeah.
Today, governments are ordered in time so that no citizen will lose basic rights for availing their vote or access to welfare schemes that are completed.
Thank you. Sri Pinaki Mishra.
Thank you, Honorable Chairman, sir. Let me just start straight away by first wishing this Honorable House, as my other colleagues from the Biju Janata Dal and Orissa have done, happy Rath Yatra from my constituency, Puri. I convey the best sentiments of the people of Orissa to this house, and I'm sure the people of Orissa will also be happy to receive reciprocal wishes from this house. Jai Jagannath, indeed. Very important, even as a member of parliament from Puri, I should have been there. I'm here today, instructed by my party, to flag certain issues before the government, and it's important enough for me, therefore, to be here. Honourable Chairman, sir, let me just straight away say that, unfortunately, Aadhaar, like GST, is really a lesson for what should obtain in this country in terms of bipartisanship. We've seen Adhiranjan Chaudhary now taking credit for Aadhaar, that we initiated it, now they're opposing it. Unfortunately, the Treasury benches today are waxing eloquent about the virtues of Aadhaar. They were opposing it when they were in the opposition. Like the GST, unfortunately, this is not good for this country, and therefore I implore.